So previously I showed you how to make this. Now the issue is right now everything is visual only. There's no data behind this. So if you need to move something over, then you actually have to copy and paste it over and modify everything, and it's not very streamlined. What if instead we actually want to create something like this, where we have a table of data, and then when you change things, it will automatically update your chart for you. But we can do that, and it's really not too hard. Let's just go ahead and close this out, and I don't need to save. And let's start just a new one. We're going to go ahead and start with blank. Here you see we have just a blank spreadsheet. Let's just shrink this down a little bit. I don't need that much. I need, let's see, tasks, start time, duration. That's what I need for this. So I need four columns, and it looks like around 30 rows. So let's bring this to 30. And we can always add more if we need more. I don't need the inspector right now, it's in the way, so let's get rid of that. All right, so very first thing. I'm just going to go ahead and copy and paste my tasks in there. So there we go, tasks 30, good guess. And this will be our start time, and this will be our duration, and this will be who. Okay, so for start time, I'm just going to go straight down this list and add it in from the chart that I made. So this starts at 0, the drive starts at 0. Well, that was at 10 before I moved it, so we'll put 10 and 10 and 10, 10, 10. We put checkout at 30, and we put the drive at 50 just in case. And for duration, I just go ahead and put this in. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we said maybe up to 60 minutes. That was 10. All of these were 20 because didn't put an order because not sure exactly where they are in the store. So 20 for that and 10 for that. And we'll get to this who part later. So for prep time, put starting at 60. I'm just going to put minutes in for this. I'm not going to try messing with hours. It'll just be easier. And duration was 20. We put that as also 60, and we estimated 20. And this was, all of these are actually at 60. So 60, 60, 60, 10, 10, 10. All right, so that part's done. This one was a little bit more complicated because put a little bit of a stretch here based on when going from one person to three people. So this is starting officially at 40, and it spans across 50 minutes, even though there's a 30-minute break in between. That's just how that one plays out, and that's okay. This one's at, that's 80, so 60 and 20, so 80 minutes. This is 10, that's 10. For eating, we have it start at 40. And once again, it's very similar to the previous one. You've got this big gap in between. But that's just the way it is. So for eating, we put that at, that's actually, that would be 90 there, so that's 100, so 100 minutes. And for duration, this would be 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So 70. And this is 10, that's 10. This we allotted 20. Being that there's more people there, it's actually probably going to be longer because you'll probably chat and whatnot. You probably won't just shove it into your face, but you know, that's okay, whatever. You get the point. Post dinner is really easy. We put this at, it's 110 minutes, so 60 plus 50. So 110, and we just put all of these, oops, these should all be 110. And put 10 minutes as a duration for each of these. All right. Now for this, the category, the who, we can do two things. I could either type it in each time. So like Actually, for these, it would be like cats for category, because I don't want that labeled as a person, since it's often going to vary. And I could do that. And I could put this in for Tom. And I can Command-C and Command-V. And that's fine, if that's the way that I want to do it. I could also, instead, if I wanted to, go into my inspector, and I could tell this that I want all of these to be a pop-up menu. And so now I have these options. I don't like these options, but I can change them. So this could be cat for category. This could be mine. This could be, come on, there we go, Tom and Kim and all or everyone. So there we go. And now for each one of these, I have a drop-down menu that I can choose. Now that's still not very efficient, so I'm going to Command-C and Command-V as appropriate for each of these, just because it's faster and more efficient. So this one was whom? All right, so this one was mine. And that's also for this one. That's also for cleaning the table and setting the table. All right, shredding the cheese was Tom. So there's Tom. Cutting the lettuce was Kim. That's also Kim there. And that one is everyone. Is also everyone, and then these three were all mine. So there we go, now I have a nice table. Now what I can do with this is I can highlight the whole thing, and I can make a chart. This is the one that I want. It will be the one that looks the most like a Gantt chart. So you can see it here, it's not quite right yet, but bear with me, and we will make it look more the way you're expecting. So currently, we have start time, and we have all this blue in the way, and that's not really what we want. What we want to do is we want to click on the chart, then click the column, so we have just this column selected. We want to change the fill to nothing. So now that's much more what you're expecting. And we can actually go ahead and delete this label out, too, if we want to. Now, who doesn't really show up in here? Not with the way that we did this. If we want it to be color coordinated the way that this was, we actually have to do it a different way. And it's a bit more complex. So I'll show you that real fast too. And to do that, I'm going to go ahead and delete the graph. Because what I actually need to do instead is add a few more columns. So instead of having duration, it's going to be more like category and then each person's name. And if you don't understand why yet, it will all make sense shortly. So what we'll do here is we're going to have to drop the value, or whoever it's assigned to, in their column. So that makes it pretty easy for category because it's already in the right column, so that's why I just deleted those. If this is this column, then I need to replace it for each one. So this becomes 20, this becomes 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. So I can go ahead and remove those out of there now because they don't need to be in the other one anymore. That looks good. Now for Tom, so 10, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, and 10. The reason why I did copy and paste for this one is because right now they were set to these drop downs, and if I tried to type in it, it's not going to work because I would have to change the format over here, which I could do, but that takes longer than just copying and pasting. So an efficiency thing going on there. And so I'm going to copy a blank cell that is not a dropdown. It could be any blank cell. And I'm going to paste over all of these, so that way they're no longer categories and they're just empty blank cells. And I didn't mean to go that far. There we go. Which means I can also delete these out of here now, because I've put them in the right, in the right column. Let's see, there's one for Tom. So let's go ahead and delete that, and we'll replace that, and delete that. And that looks good. All right, so now for this column, so that's 10 and 10. So that's gone, gone, gone. And now all, so 10, 20. Get rid of that one, get rid of that one, and that one. So there we go, we just converted it from the other one to this one. Now, right now that might be a little confusing, but it's all right. If I click on this whole graph here, I can tell it charts, and I can make a new chart. And this is much closer to what we're expecting. Now, there's not a lot of room on here because of the size of this chart. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to cut the chart. So Command X. And I'm going to make a new sheet. So just right-click, add new sheet. Delete that. Command V, so I have my chart here. Let's move this down here, and now we can make this much bigger. Move that over so I can move the whole thing over since it's attached, and that's looking pretty decent. The start time is an issue that it's all blue, so just like before, we need to go into that, so we click on the graph. And since we don't have them on the same one anymore, we can't just go back and click on the table. It doesn't work very well. It's actually easier just to go here and click on the color we want to change a couple times until it shows just that one, and we can tell it no fill. So this is looking pretty close to what we want. Now right now, these little lines, it makes it really hard to read because these values are too far apart. So we can change that too. If we go here in the inspector, we can increase the number of steps until it looks the way that we want, or until we max it out. And we can even tell it what the max is too. So we could do 120 there, so that way it uses up the whole space. All right, so there you go. A Gantt chart, more the way that you're used to seeing, with color-coded for who's working on what, along with large bands for the categories. And we can clean this up a little bit. We could remove start time there if we want to, because it doesn't make any sense since you can't see it. And we could change the title of the chart up here as well, just with a double click. Marvelous.